Very good morning to all of you. I am Neetu Gailor. I am working as an assistant professor in St. Andrews Institute of Technology and Management, Gurgaon. I am taking biology subject of electrical department. And today, my 14th lecture, in which lecture we are discussing the topic, these are the cellulose and disaccharides here. So now come to the topic, that is, first is the cellulose. As we know that the cellulose is the example of polysaccharides, okay? Because we are studying now the carbohydrates and the polysaccharides are the part of carbohydrates. And here, the cellulose is the type of polysaccharides. So, firstly, we should know that the polysaccharides are formed when a large number of monosaccharide molecules join together with the elimination of the water molecule. So thus the polysaccharide may be regarded as condensation polymer in which the monosaccharides are joined together by the glycoside linkage. Or important polysaccharides are, these are the starch, cellulose, glycogen, and the dextrins. So now, in this lecture, we are discussing about the cellulose. So firstly, goes to the cellulose. We know that the cellulose is the compound that gives the rigidity of the cells. Plant cell wall are made up of cellulose. We all know that, and the rigid structure of cellulose is what allows plants to stand upright. So the bond between the each cellulose molecule are very, very strong, which makes the cellulose very hard to break down. And we know the molecular mass of the cellulose varies from 50,000 to 5 lakh, suggesting thereby that cellulose may contain the 300 to 3000 glucose unit. So the now we know the units of the glucose in the cellulose. So the, we know that the cellulose contains 300 to 3000 glucose unit, and it is the chief component of cotton, wood, jute, etc. So the wood contains about 40 to 45% cellulose, rest being are the lignins and the resins. And the cotton contains about 90 to 95% cellulose, and the rest are the fats and the waxes. So these are the, this is the general information about the cellulose. Now come to the properties. The cellulose is a, as we know that it is a water insoluble polysaccharides and made up of the thousand of the glucose molecule, and has a great tensile strength. So it helps the cell maintains and shape of the plant, and tolerate the pressure which is excreted from the fluid contained in the cell. But unlike starch, cellulose is also non-reducing, since it does not reduce tolerance resistant in the failing solution. Okay, or and unlike starch, it does not undergo the hydrolysis easily. So cellulose, the formula of the cellulose is C6H10O5N. So it is composed of glucose monomer. Cellulose does not hydrolyze easily, but on heating with the dilute H2SO4, it undergoes and the pressure applied, so it does undergoes the hydrolysis to give only the D glucose. Okay, so here is the structure. The glucose is the linear condensation of polymer cellulose. Cellulose is the linear condensation of polymer of beta D glucose, in which the C1 of one glucose unit is connected to the C4 of the other through beta glucoside linkage. Here in the, this is the structure of the cellulose. So we can see here that there are the three units of the glucose, and this is the first unit, and we can see here the first C carbon of first unit is attached to the fourth carbon of the second glucose unit. Okay, and these are joined together by a ग्लूकोसाइड लिंकेज और इट इज कॉल्ड द बीटा लिंकेज. Now this is the third unit of the glucose, and here we can see that the second and the third unit are joined to the first carbon of second unit and the fourth carbon of the third unit. So it is the structure of the cellulose. Now one more important thing, that why the cellulose not digested? Cellulose digest kyun nahi hota? So we know that in the human digestive system, so there are the cellulase enzyme is not present. Okay, so the in the human being digestive system, so the it does not contain the enzyme cellulase, or which can hydrolyze cellulose into glucose. Agar cellulase enzyme nahi hai, to fir hydrolyze nahi hoga wo glucose mein. So the cellulase enzyme hydrolyze the cellulose into glucose and hence cannot digest cellulose. And the function of the cellulose, so cellulose make up about 30% of the plant cell wall and connecting cell to form tissues, and it control the shape of the plant. So this is the cellulose. So now I complete the cellulose and goes to the next topic, that is the disaccharides. Now the next second topic is the disaccharides. Disaccharides are the also the part of the carbohydrates. We know that the carbohydrates are classified into three main categories. They are, the first is the monosaccharides, second is the disaccharides, and third is the polysaccharides. So we have already discussed the monosaccharides, in which we have discussed the glucose and the fructose. So now come to the disaccharides. In this, in the disaccharides, they are the example of the sucrose and the lactose here. So now, firstly discussing about the general information of the disaccharides. The carbohydrates which upon hydrolysis give two molecules of the same or different monosaccharides. Clear? These are called the disaccharides. The general formula: C12H22O11 for all the sucrose, all the disaccharides. So here the disaccharides are the sucrose, maltose, lactose, and the each have the same molecular, same formula, general formula, or we can say this is the C12H22O11. Okay, now there are the reaction. In this reaction, we can show that here is the first reaction, and there the sucrose, I mean C12H22O11, when it got hydrolyzed in the presence of invertase enzyme, so it gets glucose and the fructose. So both have the same formula, C6H12O6 and C6H12O6. And now, what is the difference between the glucose and the fructose? Both have the same formula, but what is the difference between glucose and the fructose? So here, you should remember that in the glucose, there are the aldehyde functional group, and in the fructose, there are the keto functional group is present. So this is the main difference of the between the glucose and the fructose. Now come to the second, is the maltose, C12H22O11. It got hydrolyzed in the presence of maltase enzyme, and is the formation of the same type of monosaccharides. These are the glucose and the glucose also. Okay, this is the glucose formation. Now the come to the lactose. Lactose C12H22O11 plus water molecule in the presence of lactase enzyme. So it means ki sabke liye ek particular enzyme hume chahiye. In the presence of lactase enzyme, lactose gives the glucose and the galactose. And here these are again same, have the same molecule, same formula. Now the two monosaccharide unit are joined together through a ethanol or oxide linkage formed by loss of water molecules. Such a linkage between two monosaccharides unit through oxygen is called the glucoside linkage. With the basic information of the disaccharides, it means jab two monosaccharides are joined honge, so there is a joined by the glycoside linkage. Now come to the example of the disaccharide. Here the example is the sucrose. So this is the formula of sucrose. The formula is the C12H22O11. Clear? So it is the most common disaccharide and is widely distributed in plant. It is colorless, crystalline, water soluble, sweet substance. On hydrolysis with the dilute hydrochloric acid or in the presence of enzyme invertase or sucrase, so it gives and it gives one unimolar mixture of D positive glucose and D negative glucose. Okay, I repeat again, the most common disaccharide is the sucrose. It is widely distributed in plant. It is colorless, it is crystalline, it is water soluble sweet substance. On hydrolysis, in hydrolysis with the dilute hydrochloric acid or in the presence of enzyme, it may be sucrase or the invertase. So it gives a unimolecular mixture of the D positive glucose and the D negative glucose. Here is the reaction. The C12S2211 is the sucrose. And after the hydrolysis, it gives the glucose and the fructose also. So C6H12O6, again C6H12O6. Now the structure of the sucrose. Here, since sucrose is a non-reducing sugar, so therefore the two monosaccharide units, one is glucose and another is the fructose. They are joined together by a linkage. So here we can see the first structure is of glucose and the second structure is of fructose. So here we can see that is the glucose unit. We can count the number of carbon atoms. These are the 6 carbon atoms. And in the fructose structure, so there are the again 6 carbon atoms. But in the here the functional group is aldehyde, and the fruit in the fructose there the functional group is keto group. And here we can see that the carbon number 1 and of the glucose unit and the carbon number 2 of the fructose unit, they are joined together by the glycoside linkage. Okay, so this is the structure of the sucrose. Now come to the properties. There are the some properties, like first of all, the property is the molecular weight. So we can see that the molecular weight is 342.30 gram per mole. Then the density, it is the 1.587 gram per centimeter cube. And physically, we can see that it is a white crystalline solid. Here the melting point, it decompose at the 459 Kelvin. It decompose over. So these are the properties. And now come to the uses of the sucrose. We all know about the uses of the sucrose. But the sucrose form a major element in confectionery and the dessert. Cooks use it for the sweetening. Meetha ki jagah hum log use karte hain. It can also act as food preservative when used in the sufficient concentration. So these are the main uses of the sucrose. So we know the all these are the uses of the sucrose here. So we know about the cellulose, and another thing is the sucrose. I repeat the lecture of the here we can again study by the of the sucrose. So we know that sucrose is the disaccharides carbohydrate. Okay, so we can see here that it is a disaccharide carbohydrate, and the carbohydrate which upon hydrolysis gives the two molecules of the same or the different monosaccharides. The formula of the sucrose is the C12S2211, and they are the three types of the disaccharides versus the sucrose. Second is the maltose and the lactose, and each have the same formula C12S2211. Here is the reactions. We can see the enzyme is must required for the hydrolysis. So sucrose in the presence of invertase enzyme, it gives the glucose fructose, and the maltose in the presence of maltase enzyme for hydrolysis, it gives the glucose and the next unit glucose. And lactose on the hydrolysis with the presence of lactase enzyme, so it gives the glucose and the galactose also. So there is the hydrolysis of the sucrose. sucrose, maltose, and lactose. Now we know that the two monosaccharide units are joined together by the glycoside linkage. You know, or we can say that here the first carbon of glucose and the second carbon of the fructose, these are joined together. And just a minute, they join together with the oxygen, and it is called the glycoside linkage. So this is the structure of the sucrose. Here is again the reaction by which we can see that the hydrolysis of the sucrose, and it gives the glucose and the fructose, and it is also called the D positive glucose and the D negative glucose. Okay, and in the presence of the dilute hydrochloric acid. Now, the structure of sucrose we have already completed, and now we know the properties of the sucrose and the uses of the sucrose also. Now, here the one more topic is also is present here. These are the part of the lipids. In the lipids, we have a general discussion. We have already discussed the general information about the lipids, but here are the two main examples. These are the phospholipids, and the another is the cholesterol. So in this lecture, I add these information about the phospholipids and the cholesterol also. And here we know that the phospholipids are the part of the compound lipids. It is a type of compound lipids. So here we can see that the phospholipids are the triglycerides in which one fatty acid is replaced by the phosphoric group acid. So which is often linked to additional nitrogen group like the choline, etc. and ethylenamine. You know, so the here this is the structure of the phospholipids. Here the phospholipids are the lipids containing a phosphate group. Okay, containing the phosphate group. The components, the commonest type of the commonest type is formed when one or the three groups of OH and OH groups of glycerol, they combine with the phosphoric acid instead of the fatty acid. Here is the structure when the glycerol with the two fatty acids here, and it is the phosphoric acid is linked together, and there the condensation reaction takes place, and the elimination of the water molecule, and now the formation of the phospholipids. So this is the structure of the phospholipids. And the second type of the lipid that is come to the derived lipids, come from the derived lipids. So here the example is the cholesterol. So a fat, cholesterol is a fat soluble with crystalline sterol or steroid alcohol. The formula is the C27H45OH, and it has the 7 carbon nucleus of 4 fused hydrocarbon ring. There is a 3 hexane 1 pentane cyclopentano per hydroxyphenanthrene. So there are the 8 carbon and 8 carbon side chain is attached at C17. So normal cholesterol concentration of the blood is 142 to 50 milligram per 100 ml. So this is the structure of the cholesterol and the function of the cholesterol. It helps in the formation of the bile salts and bile acid, and the next function is that it forms a vitamin D near the surface of radiant skin, and it forms the steroid hormones in the adrenal glands, and it produces the sex hormones, and these are the progesterone and the estrogen for the female, and the testosterone sex hormone for them, it is a male sex hormone. So it produces these is the main functions of the cholesterol. I repeat, the function of the cholesterol is important. First is the help in the formation of bile salts and the bile acids. Then the forms of vitamin D near the surface of the irradiant skin. Okay, then the third is that it forms the स्टीरॉयड हार्मोन्स इन द एड्रिनल ग्लैंड, है ना, और देन द इम्पोर्टेंट इज इट प्रोड्यूस द सेक्स हार्मोन्स एंड द मेल सेक्स हार्मोन्स आर कॉल्ड द टेस्टोस्टेरोन एंड द फीमेल सेक्स हार्मोन्स आर कॉल्ड द प्रोग्रेस्टेरोन एंड द एस्ट्रोजन. सो नाउ इन दिस लेक्चर वी हैव कंप्लीट अवर सेकेंड यूनिट. In this unit, we have already completed the carbohydrate, lipids, amino acid, proteins, these topics with their examples. So now I complete my second unit, and all other things which are related to the second unit we have already completed. So I in our next lecture we are going with the unit number 3, and that is the biochemistry. In biochemistry, the third unit of the biology subject. So in our next lecture we are going to discuss about the biochemistry. So now I complete my lecture. Thank you so much.